Hey, what's up guys, it's Kausubh here, back with another video. And in this video, as per the title, we will be taking a look at the Sierdroid version 6.8 custom ROM, which is based upon Android 10 for the OnePlus 3T. And as per the drill guys, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. As per the drill, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. Firstly guys, this is the device of choice. This is the OnePlus 3T which I'm using, and I have right now installed the Sierdroid version 6.8 on this one, and it works pretty well, I should say, but it has some flaws in it which I will tell you later in the video. So firstly, we will take a look at the about info of this ROM here. If I go in Android 10, so here as you can see, we are currently running on Android version 10, so that's the latest version of Android which we get. Then Sierdroid version is 6.8, so this is the latest build. Like previously it was having 6.5, and it is like a 2 version upgrade directly from 6.5. We got a 6.8 update, and the security patch level is July 1, so that is the latest security patch. Then kernel is a Lineage OS kernel that we get. I have not meshed with the kernel guys, I've just kept it stock as it is. Build date is July 10. This is the latest and the greatest Sierdroid has to offer, and it is based upon Android 10. After taking a look at the ROM info guys, now it's time to take a look at the ROM customizations, display and ROM customization. So if I go into display here, then we have got all the basic settings, that is dark theme is there, live display is also there, we have got color profile in here, display adjustments are also present, that's there. Then styles and wallpaper is also something basic that comes with each and every Android 10 custom ROM. Display size can be also customized. Lock screen display, here we have got a couple of lock screen settings as well, and that's about it in display customizations. Now I will go into the ROM customizations here. As we can see, we have got a separate menu, that is Sierdroid settings, and on top of there we have got all the tabs. We get all status bar, quick settings, lock screen, navigation, buttons, user interface, notifications, sound, miscellaneous about Sierdroid. So we have all the customization settings that you ever might need. And also like icons can also be changed, battery style, and all of them. I will not go into depth, there are a lot of customizations. You can check it out whenever you install this custom ROM. So customization wise, this ROM is up there. Talking about the security features of this ROM, the guys, this ROM comes with face unlock by default. So that's a nice thing, that most of the custom ROMs are now coming with face unlock now that Google has officially removed face unlock from its GApps package. So here in security, under face unlock, so here we can set up your face and it works pretty much all the time, so it's quite helpful rather than using your fingerprint scanner. Also guys, talking about network, then we have got the Volt symbol right here. As you guys can see, VoLTE is working absolutely fine. Currently I have the Airtel India SIM in my phone, so Volt is working for me. In mobile network, as we can see, Volt is working absolutely fine, so no problems with VoLTE as well. About the camera performance of this ROM, so by default, as always, this ROM comes with AOSP camera app, which is not that great enough. I would suggest you to try out Gcam mod, and I have Gcam mod version 7.3 installed on this phone again. I will just quickly show you one camera sample with this, and just turn HDR enhanced, which gives you really high quality images, and just focus and click a photo. So guys, here is a photo clicked with the Gcam right now, and as you can see, the clarity is really absolutely mind-blowing. Like the image quality just goes to another level if you use Gcam with the OnePlus 3T. So as always, I would recommend you to try out Gcam mod, and if you want to check a full review about the Gcam, you can check out in this video right here. After the camera performance guys, we will be taking a look at the battery life, and I'm sad to inform that the battery life is not great on Sierdroid version 6.8 guys. And right now, just don't get confused, because all of you have been asking me which is the best ROM for the 3T. I have been always suggesting you to use Sierdroid version 5.10. so version 5.10 is based upon Android Pie, and this one which I have installed, this is the version 6.8, and this one is based upon Android 10. So in battery, if we go here, right now I'm on 84% of charge, and we get the battery modes, which was seen lastly in like the Pi build of this ROM. So we have all of these battery modes. It works pretty well, like the battery modes to work, and if you put it on battery save, it does save a lot of battery, but the device starts lagging. So I prefer keeping it on quick, because if I keep it on balanced guys, I have noticed a lot of lag. like while scrolling through the app menu or while scrolling through my Twitter feed, I have observed this lag, especially in Twitter and Instagram, which I've observed, like as you guys can see right now, it is lagging. So this should not be the case. Like in other ROMs, it used to work absolutely buttery smooth, but with this one, if I keep it in normal, it just lags, literally it lags, and also it heats up with normal usage, so that's also not that great. So right now battery temperature, as you can see, is 37. It should be ideally around 32 or 33 sort of. So the device does heat up a lot, and the performance, like the overall smoothness is not there. This is not a polished ROM, I should say. Lastly, talking about guys is the launcher itself. So we get the default CR.Droid launcher here, and if I go into the settings here, as you can see, we have got only basic options. Not a lot of customization options are present on this CR.Droid launcher. All the basic options are still there. This launcher is not the best, I should say, because I was getting a lot of random system crashes. So that's about it for the launcher. So finally guys, concluding the video, if you are looking forward to installing this ROM, I would not suggest you to go for this ROM. I just made this review so that all of you guys can get a brief idea as to how this CR.Droid version 6.8 is performing. But in my testing, at least it was not that well. Battery life is not that stable, and also the performance is a bit laggy somewhat, so it is not absolutely stable. And if you are looking for a stable Android 10 ROM, then just try out Evolution X. I have also made a video about it right here, as you can see in this card, so you can try that ROM out for Android 10. So that's about it guys for this video. I hope you guys have liked this video, and if you like it, then please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel for more awesome content. This is your boy Kaustubia from D2E signing off. You guys have a great day.